Welcome to my channel PRS Programming. Today's topic is method overloading. In this video, we will learn after reading the question how we can decide that how to overload the method, what are the basic things that we should know while writing a program related to method overloading, what are the precautions that we should take while writing the program. But in this video, we will learn how to find out the area of parallelogram, rhombus and trapezium. How, based on the formula, we will decide to overload the method, we'll learn while writing program. Now it's time to check the question. Here the question is saying that define a class area, that means class name is specified, using method overloading. That means question is also tells about method overloading. Is there any method name specified? Let's check. Find area. Obviously, it is saying that the name of the method is find area. We know that in case of method overloading, method name must be same. So whose area it is asking to calculate? To calculate the area of the following. What are they? Parallelogram, rhombus and trapezium. In order to calculate the area of all these three, I will use the method name find area. But also a restriction is there in method overloading. The parameter must be different. So while writing the program, we'll take the precaution on this particular part. As I said that while overloading the method, method name is same, but parameter must be different. How we can distinguish the parameter? We'll decide it using the formula. Now here it says that parallelogram formula is space into height. Here it says that half into diagonal 1 into diagonal 2. Here it says that half into a plus b into h. So what are the unknown variables? Here we have two variables. I'm writing over here. Here also I have two variables. There I'm having a risk. That means these two methods data type must be different. And here I'm using half. We'll decide while writing the program. And here we don't have any problem because it is having three parameters. So number of parameter is different from this to this and this to this. Not an issue. But the problem is between these two. Number of parameter is same. So in that case, we'll change the data type. That means types of parameter. So let's see how we can apply it in program. So first job is to use import statement. Import java.util.star. After that, class name, public class. Class name as per the question area, inside which my first job is to define the method. As we know that method is having return type, but in question nothing is specified regarding return type. So I will take void, but method name was given find area. Now the precaution related to your parameter. It must take parameter because it is talking about base and height. So I will take float base and float height. Inside this, I will calculate the area of parallelogram. So I will take one more variable over here to store the area. Float area of parallelogram is equal to base into height. After calculating, I will display it. So I will say system.out.println. Inside this, I will give the message area of parallelogram where it is available in AP. So first method job is over. Look for the second one. Again, void find area, because method name must be same. Again, we'll think about the parameter. It is diagonal 1 into diagonal 2. Already we have taken two parameter with float, so I cannot take, but here it is having half into diagonal 1 into diagonal 2. So that's why it must be float or double. So I will say double. That's why I'm changing the type of parameter. I'm saying diagonal 1, comma, double diagonal 2. In order to store the result, I will take double area of rhombus is equal to 0.5 for half. into diagonal 1 into diagonal 2. Again, I will display the message system.out.println. Message will be area of rhombus stored in AR. Second method is over. Now the third one is void find area. Again, parameter. It is saying that half into sum of two sides into distance of your diagonal. That is your h. As per the formula, half into two sides addition into h. So for that reason, it is taking three parameter. We don't have any problem because above two method is taking two parameter and this needs three parameter. So directly without any hesitation, I am taking double side one, double side two, double h to store the result. I am saying double area of trapezium is equal to 0.5 per half into side one plus side two into h. It will not give me the desired result because multiplication is having highest priority than addition. Here what it will do, it will multiply 0.5 with s1, then s2 into h. After that it will add it. So that's why I have to put it within parentheses to give highest priority. Now I will display the message system.out.println. Message is area of trapezium stored in AT. All the parts of method overloading is over. Now it's job to write the main method, which is our main job. So it is public static void main string within square bracket. I can take any object. So I'm taking S over here. Inside this, my first job is to create an object of the class. So I will say area AA is equals to new area. Object is created. I need to accept the data. So that's why I will use the scanner class object. New scanner within parenthesis system.in. Preliminary job is over. Now the next job is count how many float variables are there. Two float variables. So parallelly declare over here float. What we had taken, based on that you take it, or you can take any different variable. I can take BA and HI for base and height, or I can take anything. So I'm taking base and height, not double. Count how many double variables I need. I need here two and here three. That is total five variables are required. So I will take diagonal one, comma diagonal two, and for the side one, side two, and h I cannot take because already I have taken h over here. So I will take h. I'm showing you we can take the same variable, we can take different variable also. Next job is to accept the data from the user. So display the message system.out.print, enter the base and height value. Now here I will say that B is equal to SS dot next float. Why? Because B is of type float. H is equal to SS dot next float. This accept part is over. Next, I will accept the data for rhombus. Display the message system dot out dot print. Enter diagonal one and diagonal two value. And we have taken the variable D1 is equal to SS dot next double. Because D1 is of type double, D2 is equal to SS dot next double. This part is over. Next, for the trapezium, display the message system.out.print. The message will be like this. Enter the side 1, comma side 2, comma h. Or we can say the parallelogram distance, D-I-S-T-A-N-S, distance value. And the variables are S1 is equal to SS dot next double. S2 is equal to SS dot next double, and we have taken HH is equal to SS dot next double. Don't get confused for the variables. So that's why while writing a program, I was always saying that take an appropriate variable name so that you will not get confused while writing the programs like this. After that, very simple, call the method. What is the object name? AA dot find area. Which one I need? I need first one for base and height. Use the local variable, don't use the formal variable that is available in the method. Use the local variable, don't use this variable. This is formal parameter, this is actual parameter. Next is find area, and I need to pass diagonal 1 and diagonal 2. Next, find area, side 1, side 2, and HH for the distance. Now let's execute it to see. Enter the value for base and height. Suppose I am saying 2.4 and 2.8. Next, diagonal 1 and diagonal 2, saying 3.3. Enter the side 1, 2.4, 2.5, distance is 6.1. We got the output over here. Sometime it may ask for menu driven program also. In the next method overloading, I will show you how we can use switch case for the menu driven program for method overloading. That's all for this video. Thank you. Do not forget to give like.